Today we will end our chapter with 1D graph generator, an application, and what is the principle, how the construction are made, everything is here. In diagram you can see it's a 1D graph generator, where you can see in the left hand side is written large copper spare. This spare is a large copper spare, and C1 and C2 are the comps. Can see here C1 is down and C2 is here, and P1 and P2 are the pulley. P1 and P2 are the pulleys to run BATS, high voltage rectifier. There is a high voltage rectifier which is connected to comp C1. M is a motor, I is insulating, M is a motor, I is insulating stand. This stand, okay, the blue one is a stand insulating, so that the ball, this copper spare is not directly connected to ground, otherwise charge will ground earth. And D is gas discharge tube, and D is a gas discharge tube. There is a discharge charge tube. Let's see what it is. And T is a target. This is a whole setup. So let's read it. Consider what is the principle of 1D graph generator. What is the use of 1D graph generator? As the name is generator, it's generate high potential. It's a device which generate high potential. Now it is in, let's see. Consider two charge conducting spare shell such that one is small and the other is larger. When the smaller one is kept inside the larger one and connected together, charge from the smaller one is transferred to the larger shell irrespective of higher potential of the larger shell. That is, charge reside on the outer shell of the outer shell, and the potential of the outer shell increase considerably. The outer shell and the potential of the sharp point, sharp point surface of a conductor have large surface charge density. Sharp pointed surface of conductor have large surface charge density, and hence the electric field created by them is very high compared to the dielectric strength of a dielectric. So the sharp end which have charge having surface charge density high, so high electric field. Therefore air surrounded these conductors, the pointed one, get ionized, and the like charges are repelled by the charge pointing conductor, causing discharge action known as corona discharge or action of point. The spray charge moving with high speed cause electric wind. The pointed metallic objects always be a source of ionization, which cause ionize surrounding air to ionize. Opposite charge are induced on teeth of conducting comb and gain. Let's see construction. 1D graph generator consists of a large copper spiracle which we have seen, supported on insulating stand IS, which is of several meters high above the ground. A belt made of insulating fabric is made to run over the pulley P1 and P2, operated by an electric motor M, such that it's ascend on the side of climb. Comb C1 near the lower pulley is connected to high voltage rectifier HVR, whose other end is earth. Comb C2 near the upper pulley is connected to spare S through a conducting rod. A tube T with a charge particle to be accelerated as it top, and the target at the bottom is placed as shown in figure. The bottom of the tube is earth for maintaining lower potential. To avoid the leakage of charge from the spare, the generator is enclosed in a steel tank filled with air. Vacuum. Let the positive terminal of the high voltage rectifier is connected to comb C1. Due to action of point, electric wind is caused and positive charge are spread on the belt. You can see down here, this HRS, this comb C1 is connected to high voltage rectifier, so comb C is positively charged, and as we have comb is very having sharp edges, so the wind around it also ionized, so they form positive charge as well. And these positive wind is taken by this pulley, this rubber belt, which is connected through this pulley. Okay. So the comb C1 being negatively charged cause electric wind by spraying okay, which are carried by conduction to inner surface of it is very easy. Let me explain. Comb C is now positive, having positive charge, and this positive charge are as this belt is made of insulating material. Okay, so this positive charge induced on the belt, and so the positive charge induced on the belt, and when the motor rotates, so this positive charge moved in upper direction. As they move up and reaches to comb C2, you can see here the same charge is received by C2, and so it transfer to the outer edge, okay, outer surface of S, and again from B2 come back and ground it, and from D it becomes grounded. This is how the C from C1 positive charges are keep going to C2, and C2 receive these charges and throw the outer surface of throw. I'm using a general language, okay. So a tube T with charge, the comb being negatively charged cause electric wind by the spraying negative charge due to action of point which neutralize the positive charge on the belt. Therefore, the belt does not carry any charge back while descending. Okay. The process continue for a longer time to store more and more charges on the spare, outer sphere of spare, and the potential of the spare increase. As we have known, the potential is related to number of charges. The more you give the charge, the more the spare increase considerably. When the charge on the spare is very high, the leakage of charge due to ionization of surrounding air also increases. Maximum potential occurs when the rate of charge carried in by belt is equal to rate of the charge leak from shell due to ionization failure. Now, if the positively charged particle which are to be accelerated are kept at top of the tube T, they get accelerated due to difference in potential. Wendy Graf generator, what is the use? Wendy Graf generator used to produce very high potential difference for accelerating charge particle. The beam of accelerated charge particle are used to trigger nuclear reaction. What is the use? As we know, the Wendy Graf generator used to produce high potential difference. And due to this potential difference, particles, accelerating charge particle, basically alpha particles. Beam of accelerated charge particle used to trigger nuclear reaction. As we have known, for uranium 235 and others, we need neutrons. So this is how they do it. Break atoms from various experiment phase. So that was all about chapter 3, chapter 2, and that was last section of. So in the next chapter, you could say from today on. So we are reaching. And remember, Wendy Graf generator is important topic. Okay, now current electricity. Current electricity in this section. Now our first two chapters are over, which was related to static current. The charges are red. Now, current electricity is related to charge when charges are in motions. So this is a very different. This very much. So how? When the charge are in motions, how they behave. Earlier it was all static, rest. As if you read this introduction, all charges, whether free or bound, are considered to be at rest. Charges in motion constitute an electric current. Such current occur naturally in many situations. Lighting is one such phenomena in which charges flow from cloud to the earth through एटमोसफियर समटाइम्स विथ डिजास्ट्रस द फ्लो ऑफ चार्जेस इन लैंडिंग इज नॉट स्टडी बट इन आवर एवरीडे लाइफ वी सी मैनी डिवाइसेज विद चार्जेस फ्लो इन स्टडी मैनर द फ्लो ऑफ चार्जेस इन लैंडिंग इज नॉट स्टडी बट इन आवर एवरीडे लाइफ वी सी मैनी डिवाइसेज विद चार्ज फ्लो इन स्टडी मैनर लाइक वाटर फ्लोइंग स्मूथली वाटर अ टॉर्च एंड अ सेल्फ ड्राइवन क्लॉक आर एग्जाम्पल ऑफ सच डिवाइस In present chapter, we shall study some of the basic law concerning steady electric current. What is electric current? We have already studied in class 10th. Imagine a small area held normally to the direction of flow of charges. Imagine a small area held normal to the direction of flow of charges. Any direction? Both the positive and negative charges may flow forward and backward across area. In a given time interval t, let q plus be the net amount of positive charge that flow in forward direction across the area. Similarly, q minus be the net amount of negative charges flowing across the area in forward direction. The net amount of charges flowing across the area in forward direction in time interval t then is net amount of charge. This proportion to t of steady current. And the quotient I is equal to Q upon T. So define the current across area in forward direction. It implies the current is in backward direction. Current are not always steady, and hence more generally we define the current as follows. Let delta Q be the net charge flowing across a section, cross section of conductor during a time interval dt. Then the current at time t across the cross section of conductor is defined as value of ratio of dq to dt in limit of delta t tends to 0. So it is limit is a mathematical formula delta q upon delta c. So this is the current actual mathematical formula. So it is simply rate of flow of charge per unit time in simple language. What is current? Current is rate of flow of charge per unit time through a conducting wire, through a conductor. In SI unit, as it is a ratio of simple charge upon time, so the unit of current will be coulomb per unit second, per second, which we have defined as ampere. So coulomb is a charge unit of charge, and t is second. So coulomb per second, we call it ampere. So ampere is defined through magnetic effect of current. What electric current in a conductor? An electric charge will experience a force if an electric field is applied. We have studied in class in earlier chapter. Earlier, electric charge will experience a force if an electric field is applied. If it is free to move, it will thus move, contributed to a current. In nature, free charge particles do exist like upper strata of atmosphere called ionosphere. However, in atoms and molecules, the negative charge electrons and the positive charge nuclei are bound to each other and are thus not free to move. So in nature, yes, positive charge exists, and which is in ionosphere. However, atom and molecules, the negative charge electrons and positive charge nuclei are bound to each other and thus are not free to move, so they are not free. Bulk matter is made of many molecules. A gram of water, for example, contain approximately 10 to the power 22 molecules. These molecules are closely packed so that the electrons are no longer attached to individual. In some materials, the electron will still be bound. They will not accelerate even if an electron field is applied. Notably, metal, some of the electrons are practically free to move within the bulk manner. These materials generally called conductors. Okay, those are free electrons which we have studied, which we call them electron gas. If we want a solid conductor, then of course the atoms are tightly bound to each other so that the current is carried by negative charge electrons. There are, however, other types of conductors like electrolytic solution where positive and negative charge both can move. In our discussion, we will focus only on the solid conductor, so the current is carried by the negatively charged electron in background of fixed positive ions. Positive ions means when the electrons move, so they become atoms become positively ions. First, when no electric field is present, the electron will be moving due to thermal motion. When there is no electric field, let's read it. It's very important. You should know it. This thing also, because it's not love. Consider first the case where no electric field is present. The electrons will be moving due to thermal motion, during which they collide with fixed ions. Okay, even at the room temperature. These free electrons of any metal will be moving due to thermal will move and they collide with fixed ions. An electron collide with an ion emerge with speed as before the collisions. However, the directions of velocity after the is completely random at a given time. There is no preferential direction for the velocity of electron. Thus, on average, the number of electrons traveling in any direction will be equal to number of electrons traveling in the opposite direction. So there will be no net electric current. So even at room temperature, due to thermal agitation, we call it, the electrons move. They collide with nearest atoms and they change so accelerate, and then but the direction of acceleration not be same. So randomly, if we sum all such electron direction, we will find that the net flow of charge will be zero. So there will be no net electric current. Now, when electric current is applied, now see what happened to such piezo conductor if electric field is applied. To focus our thought, imagine the conductor in shape of cylinder of radius r. See what happened to such piezo conductor if an electric field is applied. To focus our thought, imagine the conductor is in shape of cylinder radius. Suppose we now take two thin apparatus of dielectric of same radius and put. Let us now see what happened to such piece of conductor if an electric field is applied. To focus our thought, imagine the conductor in shape of cylinder of radius r. Suppose we now take two thin circular discs of dielectric of same radius and put positive plus Q distributed over one. If an electric field is applied, to focus thought, imagine the conductor in shape of cylinder. Here is a conductor in the right hand side. You can see, suppose now taken two thin cylindrical discs of dielectric of some radius and put positive charge distributed over one disc and similarly negative charge on the other disc. We attach two discs on the two flat surfaces of cylinder. The electric field then be created and is directed from positive toward the negative charge. The electron will be accelerated due to this field toward plus Q. They will thus move and neutralize the charges. The electron, as long as they are moving, will consider the electric current. Hence, in situation considered, there will be current for a very short while no current thereafter. So here what they have a cylindrical conductor, and toward left we have a positively charged dielectric, and in the right hand side a negative charge electric. So I'm doing this. There is a potential difference, and due to this potential difference, electron move in positive conductor electron. The electrons which are present in the conductor move in the positive end and neutralize. So as long as they neutralize, the current, the electron moves. So the current thus will stop after while unless the charge plus Q or minus Q are continuously depends. So between this, if we somehow continue maintain this positive and negative. From one side electron, we keep one side we have to make the availability of free electrons, and other side the neutralization process will continue. So electron will keep on moving, and so the current will flow continuously. And here is the magic comes. It is only that positive and negative which make the electron, but to make that continuous, we need to have a device which is be called a potential difference, which create a potential difference across the ends of the conductor here and here, and that device is known as battery or cell. Using the cell and battery, so this is the major work of a cell or a battery to keep that potential difference as long as they are connected to the two end of the conductor. If there is no battery, so no flow of current takes place. So that's battery is a source to create potential difference. Remember, it make one end positive, one end negative, and that make it. Might make the flow. So it, as you can hear, mechanism which maintain the steady electric field is a battery that we shall study. We are, so now with the flow of, as we know, the flow of electron per unit time is a current. So how the, so the basic law regarding flow of Ohm's law, which we have already known, 1828, long before the physics. Imagine a conductor through which a current I is flowing, and let V be the potential difference across the end of the conductor. Then Ohm's law says the potential is directly proportional to I, or V is equal to Ri, where the constant proportionality is called resistance of the conductor. The I means resistance is Ohm, and denoted by symbol omega. Clear? That is, you already know. It is not only depend on the material of the conductor, but also in the dimension of conductor. The dependence of R on the dimension of conductor can easily be determined as follows. This proportionality constant R is resistance. And what is, and how to find R is called resistance of a conductor. So the resistance R not only depend on the material of the conductor, but only on the dimension conductor. And let's see how they are created. So here is your answers. This is the, in short, I am coming to you. The resistance R is inversely proportional to cross. These are the outcome after so many experiments. They found the resistance R is inversely proportional to the cross section area of the conductor. R is inversely proportional to 1 upon a, where A is the cross section area of a conductor. Means in if you have a cylindrical conductor, so the cross section area will be a circle. So it will be area of circle. And also here in 3.5 is also resistance is proportional to length. This is all experimenting. R is proportional to length. So there are two equations. R is proportional to length of the conductor, and resistance is proportional to area, inversely proportional to area of the conductor. And so the combining the two all, R is proportional to L upon A. Hence, for a given conductor, when you remove that proportionality sign, remember the proportionality sign, you simply remove. So R is rho, another proportionality, a proportionality constant will come, which is called rho, which is called resistivity. So B is equal to, this is, so now you can say the resistance of conductor depend on length. Higher the longer the wire, so resistance will be high, and if thinner the wire, the resistance will be high, and thicker the wire, resistance will be low. So for thick wire, resistance is always low, and for lengthy wire, this is up till now. We'll study later. Tomorrow we'll start.